Async await tasks are really, really nice. But what if you want to have multiple tasks at a time? Well, in this tutorial, I'm going to talk about that. I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com, and if you like these videos, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. And while you are at it, let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. So you know how to add an async await task, but what about setting up multiple tasks with async await? Well, that is what we are going to learn today. Before we dive into the code, let me remind you about Dev Factory. It is at rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet with me on a 16 minutes one-on-one Zoom call, where we can discuss all of your coding issues. Maybe you have a bug in your project, or if you want to learn SwiftUI, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. Quick note, this video is sponsored by WebView Gold. With WebView Gold, you can convert your web app or website into apps for iOS and Android. I get a lot of sponsored requests. Most of them I decline, but WebView Gold stood out. There's no coding required. All you have to do is set up your URL and optionally customizations. You can add here in-app purchases, push notifications. Check them out in the link in the description. Save 25% with their back-to-school sale. And now let's get back to the video. So that out of the way, let me just show you what we are going to build out today. So we are going to actually create an Xcode project that I already created a brand new one. So this is an untouched SwiftUI Xcode project. And we are going to learn how to have a data task. So a group task, sorry. So we are going to add some APIs because I don't want to set up an API. So go ahead and check out the link in the description for the resources. And all you will have to do is just drag and drop this one file into your project. Let me just drag and drop there. And let me just talk you through really, really quickly what this API is about. So it's just fetching some numbers of a certain count and in a certain range. And it is fetching those numbers in an async throws manner. So it waits for the numbers to be fetched. And what I'm doing here is having a dispatch queue main async after with a deadline of 0.5 seconds and grabbing some number, random numbers with that count and in that range and resuming with a continuation with checked throwing continuation. So from a completion type of workspace, we are now in an async throws, async await workspace. So just so you know, I do have a special YouTube video on this. It's one of the previous ones. Go ahead and check it out, how all of this works. It's really, really nice. So that's our API. We are fetching random numbers for a specific count in a specific range. Okay, so what are we going to do to make this learnable? So first of all, let's say we have an example for this. So we have, let's say, an array of UIDs that you want to fetch from the server. So you do have that array, but you want to fetch them with a task, so with async await. So you might just go with through that array with a for each or a for loop, but you will soon find out that will not work. So that is what we are going to learn today. So let's just start coding. First of all, we are going to kind of fetch that array with that random numbers, and we are going to fetch as many other random numbers as that random number in that particular array. So if it's just three, the first element of that first array is three, then we are going to fetch three random numbers. The second one is five random numbers. You will see that in just a sec. So we have the content view right over here. So let's create our content view model. So let's create a new file and name it content view model. There we go. Now, of course, this is an observable object, so let's import SwiftUI first. SwiftUI, sorry for that auto completion. And let's have a class of ContentViewModel, and the superclass will be observable object. We are going to create a fetch function, so func fetch. And this is an async throws function, meaning that we can wait for it and it might throw an error. And basically that's it for now. Let's just connect it with our content view. So let's just go back to our content view, and right over here, let's just move that out of the way so we have a little bit more space at state object view model var, so it has to be of some type, state object var view model equals, so we are initializing it, our content view model. Okay, so that's our view model. On appear, we want to fetch. So dot on appear, we want to perform something. And if you take a look at another of my YouTube videos where I detail about async await, you will know that we need to create a task right over here. And because it might throw, that fetch function in the view model might throw, we want to have this in a do catch statement. So we are going to try to await for our view model's fetch function. Okay, and on the catch part, we are just going to print out the error's localized description. So print error dot localized description. And basically that's it for our content view. Let's go back to our content view model and let's just fetch our first number. So we do have our API. So let's just try to fetch our numbers. Let's say 10 numbers. So let first numbers equals try await. So we try because it might throw, and we await because it's an async function. Okay, try await API dot and fetch numbers. Now the count would be 10 as I told you, and let's just have this as one decibel, so well, one character numbers, like from 0 to 9. So 0 dot 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 9. So that's our range. That's our first numbers. Let's just print them out. First numbers. Let's build and run this project and let's see if the first numbers will be printed out. And hopefully they will in our console. So let's just wait for this to build. And there we go, we have our 10 random numbers. Really, really nice. Okay, so what we want to do next is learn the essence of this tutorial, and that is, for each of these numbers I want to fetch, for example, for the first one I want to fetch 7 other random numbers, for the second one 4 other random numbers. So you might want to go with the 4 each for the first numbers, but that will not work because we are in an async await environment. So instead, we are going to go with a task group. So let's just do that. Let me just comment this out and let second numbers equals. And we want to, first of all, set the type of these second numbers, and that will be an array within an array, so of type int, and then try await again, try await, and with throwing task group. Now you could just go with the task group if it doesn't throw for you, but I'm just telling you that this version, because yeah, most probably your functions will throw also. So that's that. Let's just stop this so we might have a little bit more. So what is the child task result type? Well, that is actually an array of ints dot self, because yeah, we want to have 7 random numbers, so that's an array. And inside the body we want to go in out throwing task group. I'm just going to name this group, and here we have our code. So let's just type this out. It's relatively simple. You will better understand this once you see the whole code. So first of all, we want to have a kind of a return of those array of arrays. So I will just name this return second numbers. There we go. And That's an empty one. So of type int, and let's initialize that. So this is what we are starting off with. So now we can go through the first numbers for with a for each loop. So first numbers dot for each, and then first number, there we go, in. And instead of doing the async await stuff of fetching a new number from the API, we are going to add a task to our group. So group dot add task, there we go, add task. You can set a priority. I don't really care about the priority for now. Let's just delete that. And here we have our operation. So we want to here return some sort of a task. So we are returning a try await. Again, the API dot fetch numbers is a throwing async function. So here I'm going to have a count. Well, how many numbers do I want? Well, as much as the first number is, and then the close range would be like 10 and then 99. So that would be kind of, we can distinguish that. Okay, so return here. Let's fix that typo. Okay, so now that we have our groups, our task added to our group for each of the numbers, we want to go with a for loop. So for try await second number numbers in group. So now we got our group and it will give us back second numbers. The first second numbers, the second numbers, the third second numbers, and that second numbers we want to append to our return second numbers. So let's just go return second numbers dot append and second numbers. Okay, and finally, we want to kind of construct all of this. So now we have our first numbers and our return second numbers. We are still in the second numbers with throwing task group. So what we want to do is, first of all, return second numbers. Now we want to construct it. So at this point, we might want to print out the second numbers, but I'm just going to make it a little bit more readable. So for I in 0 till the first numbers count, of course, minus 1, I'm going to go and print it out like so. So print out the following. First of all, I want to number it. So I just go I plus 1, of course, because I starts with 0 here. And then let's add a dot here. So this would be the first, second, and so forth. And then I'm just going to go first numbers at I. And then let's just add a dash here. And second numbers I. And basically that's it. Let's build and run and see how this will be printed out, and it will look really, really nice. As you can see, the first one is three random numbers grabbed, 4, 4, 7, and so forth. So this is actually what we are expecting here. Again, the what you want to learn here is this with throwing task group or with task group, that okay, you have an array of some, let's say, UIDs or in this case numbers, and then for each of those you want to perform an async function with, of course, an await, or maybe it is throwable like it is in our case. So that is it. Now you know how you can use with throwing task group on multiple async functions. Now, if you do enjoy these types of videos, I highly encourage you to take a look at the Factory, a one-on-one 16-minute Zoom call with me. Just check it out at rebeloper.com/mentoring, where I can help you with your coding issues, or maybe you want to learn Swift UI or Swift in general. You can hook me up on a Zoom call. Again, it's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, that is an awesome way to handle multiple async functions at a time. So if you do like these videos, go ahead and hit that like button because it helps a lot. Go ahead and share it with your developer friends. And while you are at it, make sure to hit that notification button to get notified of new videos as I roll them out. New videos like these ones, go ahead and check them out. They are really, really cool. They are about Swift UI and Swift in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.